About 11:40 this morning, we received a call that there had been a trench collapse here at Southwest Multnomah and 54th. What we found when we arrived is workers were installing a sewage line. It's a 4-inch line. They had dug a trench that was about 9 to 11 feet deep. They had one worker in the trench at the time. They were using what we call a trench box to keep that worker protected. At some point during the operation, he ventured just outside of that trench box, in which the walls are not protected. They experienced a trench collapse, and he has been buried since that trench collapse happened, just about over an hour now. Due to the length of time that he's been buried and the amount of dirt that we're dealing with, we have a technical rescue team that is in what we call body recovery mode at this time. They have ordered some more additional equipment to come out so they can safely dig out a trench to retrieve the body. And at this point, they're just waiting for that equipment to arrive.
Can you tell us about the worker?
I can tell you that he's a 27-year-old male. He's been working with the company for just over a year. This is, it sounds like it's a family-owned company. These are, in some cases, relatives, and it's a pretty emotional scene down there right now.
This is a relative of the owner of the company?
I don't know the specifics. I just know that that company had relatives in it.
How about the folks, the OSHA folks, were those OSHA investigators on the scene?
Those were OSHA employees. We request that OSHA employees come out anytime we get called out to an incident like this for a couple reasons. One, they need to evaluate what was going on with the trench, what caused the collapse, and what caused the situation where the worker was trapped in that collapse. We also invite them to come here so that they can provide assistance with our rescue or body recovery operation.
How are your firefighter rescuers doing?
As I mentioned earlier, it's emotional down there. You know, the owner of the home who's having the work done, the co-workers, the owner of the construction company, all of these people are dealing with a great deal of grief. We have some emotional support that's being provided by what we call TIP volunteers. These are people that are trained to help out in these kind of cases. Any way you shake it, this is just it's a tough scene.
No guess as to how long they'll take to recover the body?
That's a good question. It sounds like, based on the plan they have, this will probably be an operation that'll take hours.
Hours.
Any idea why he was in that area, the unprotected area? Was he told to go over there or just accidentally went into that?
I haven't heard an explanation. You'll be able to see from some of the short video clips and photos how small the trench box is, that protected area that I was talking about, is compared to the rest of the trench. This has happened before, and I think at the end of the day, when anyone ventures outside of these parameters, these very strict guidelines, it's risky. And I think the work that these folks do is by nature a risky business. So unfortunately today we're in the middle of a body recovery because of that.